station on Space to Ground.
Welcome to Space to Ground. I'm Isidro Reyna. This week, three new crew members launched at the International Space Station. The new crew is adjusting to life on station after a successful launch and docking of their Soyuz spacecraft. The Soyuz spacecraft carrying Nick Hague and Christina Cook of NASA and Alexei Ovchinin of Roscosmos launched on Thursday, March 14th from the Baikonur Cosmodrome in Kazakhstan. Hague, Cook, and Ovchinin docked to the space station's Rosviat module after a four-orbit, six-hour journey and opened the hatch about 2 hours later. The arrival of Hague, Cook, and Ovchinin restores the station's crew complement to six. They've joined Anne McLean of NASA, David Saint-Jacques of the Canadian Space Agency, and Expedition 59 Commander Oleg Kononenko of Roscosmos. The crew members will spend more than 6 months conducting about 250 science investigations in fields such as biology, earth science, human research, physical sciences, and technology development. This week's question comes from Henning, who wants to know why spacesuits have such low pressure. Well, that's a great question, Henning. It has to do with mobility. The space station is pressurized to 14.7 pounds per square inch, pretty much what you'd find here on Earth. It's comfortable, and you can keep the space station air in a mixed nitrogen-oxygen environment. Again, very similar to Earth. U.S. spacesuits, though, are pressurized closer to 4.3 pounds per square inch. Astronauts have to spend a lot of time pre-breathing and purging nitrogen from their bloodstream to maintain a 100% oxygen environment. But the low pressure allows the suit to be a lot more flexible, which is much needed when you have to spend 6.5 hours flexing rigid space gloves to do work on the outside of the space station. Keep sending in your questions using the hashtag SpaceToGround. We'll see you next week.